Sarah Swan here. I'm a women's transformational coach and a leadership mentor, the author of Reclaim Your Power, and the creator of the Lead From Love Transformational Leadership Program and the Creatrix Mastermind Experience. And today I want to talk to you about how to show up when you feel like hiding out. And I know that this is something that comes up for a lot of feminine leaders, for not just women, but for all people. But since I work very closely with women, with leaders, with coaches, with facilitators, then I know that this can come up so often for my students who don't want to show up to circle sometimes or to sessions, to leaders who don't feel like they want to show up to their events that they've planned, to just not wanting to show up for life or for work one day. And this happens for a lot of reasons. I'm going to generalize quite a bit here, but this can happen for a lot of reasons. And the reasons that I know for myself, that I've experienced for myself, and that I feel and see happen with my clients and students, I'm going to talk about those here and invite you into some practices that will help you to show up when you most feel like you want to hide under your covers and not let the world see what's going on with you. So some of the top reasons I feel like people hide out is because we feel like we have to be perfect and we feel like we have to be on all the time. We feel as if, there's just no space for me to be anything less than at my best. So the number one thing that I want to invite you into is to be compassionate. When you're having a hard day, when it's the first day of your cycle for women, when you are going through something that's emotionally challenging, a breakup, anything at all, you don't even have to have a reason. You're just having trouble with life that day. I invite you first and foremost to be compassionate, okay? I want to first preface this with, there are times where we're not meant to show up. There are times where you've been pushing yourself too hard and that you have been going too strong and you actually need to not show up. You need to take a day off and rest. And those days happen. You need to take a month off and rest if that's possible, a week off. Like, that's why retreat and personal time and self-care is essential to avoid this burnout that can happen that is so perpetuated by our culture. But the first thing, first and foremost, that I invite you to do when you can feel yourself not wanting to show up, not wanting to go somewhere that you're supposed to be, not wanting to lead something you're supposed to lead, to be there for your clients, to be there for your friends. You just want to hide out and you're not really sure why. The first thing I invite is for you to be compassionate and to be compassionately curious about what's really going on. I feel like curiosity comes when we are compassionate with ourselves, when we actually lighten up and realize that the reason why we're not wanting to show up, there's got to be a reason for that. And with compassion and curiosity as our first step, then you're going to open up to actually understanding and possibly being able to shift it, right? You can't shift it from a place of being turned off, shut down, just not really willing to inquire about it. So compassionately curious. And in that compassion, then you may take a look and say, gosh, I've been burning the candle at both ends. I have been pushing myself. And yeah, look at me. I'm tired. I'm exhausted. If I go and do this thing, I may get sick or I may really regret it. And that is a possibility. And that is where we have to have deep self-awareness and inquiry and be willing to say, like, you know what, maybe I'm not supposed to show up, but to be responsible about it and to share why it is we're not going to be able to show up and that we need to take care of ourselves. But the other side of that, if you were to look compassionately and with curiosity at why you don't want to show up, you may realize that it's because you don't want to be seen in your vulnerability. You don't want to be seen having a hard time, and that there's a belief system at play that I need to be, have my S together and show up totally packaged and perfect at this, whatever the experience is, and not be able to really be myself. And who would want to go to anything where you can't be yourself? And my guess is you've had the experience of going to something somewhere, whether it be work-related or personal or parties or whatever it may be, where it just feels yucky because you don't feel like you're going there and being yourself. So get curious about that. Ask yourself, am I perhaps just not able to show my true self or feel like I can be my true self in these circumstances? And that leads me to number two, is to be willing to be real. Be willing to be vulnerable. Be willing to be seen in your imperfection. Why don't we start to normalize? I know in some communities, in some circles, in some groups, it is totally normal to be vulnerable and to share what's on your mind and what's on your heart. It's not the norm in our culture, but why don't we start to normalize that more and more for men and women to be able to show up when we're not doing okay and to not, you know, sit there and drag the whole world down and invite everybody into feeling miserable. That's not what I'm saying. I'm saying, why don't we show up courageously and be vulnerable with where we're at? Be vulnerable with what you're feeling and be willing to be a human being who is not always on, happy, and perfect. This world has all kinds of painful and difficult experiences that we go through as human beings on a daily basis. Turn on the news and you're likely going to be very depressed. You know, depression is actually really understandable given the state of the world. And so is joy, given all the opportunities for joy and beauty and connection and love. So why do we always make only joy and happiness and upbeat positivity okay and normalized, but not actually feeling the other very real, very raw, very normal emotions that we feel when we're hit with a difficult circumstance or we are depressed of a certain condition in the world? Why is it not okay to feel that and move through it to the other side? So often we get stuck in it, and when we want to hide out and not be in the world, it's because it's not normalized or okay to be feeling these darker, more difficult feelings. But they're normal and it's okay. And the reason why we stay stuck there is because we don't feel safe to be seen and share them. So I invite you to be willing to be vulnerable, be willing to be seen, be willing to show up and to share, this is where I'm at, I'm okay with it, you know, I'm here, I'm committed, I'm willing to be here, but this is what's going on for me. And then the third thing is to be willing to be brave and to ask for what you need. Like, so many times you don't want to show up to like be with a group of friends or to do something because you may feel like, I'm not going to get my needs met. I'm going to be a burden. I don't want to have to, you know, stand the whole time at this, whatever. And so you just like, I'm not going to go. Just screw it. Like, I'm not going to go. And the opportunity there is actually to ask for what you need. Let's say that you're supposed to meet with a friend and you're really exhausted and you really need to rest, but she wants to go out, you know, to a bar or drinking or whatever it may be. But for you, like, that's just, you're exhausted. That's not going to be fun. That's not going to be taking care of your body. So perhaps there's a way that you can be brave, be courageous, and say, you know what I really need tonight is some downtime. I really would love to just get tea, to go sit at the beach, to go, you know, to go and just be together or rest or sit on the couch or whatever it may be, so that you're honoring your commitment, you're honoring and showing up still, but doing it in a way that honors your needs as well and compromises, right? And that can happen in so many different ways, and how even like if you're supposed to speak at an event or you're supposed to, whatever it may be, to ask like, listen, I'm really going to need tea at this event and I'm going to need to sit down and I'm going to need to tell the audience that I'm really like low energy, but I'm there and I'm committed and I want to deliver and support. Like, show up with your heart. Be authentic, but be willing, be brave enough to ask for what you need and to be vulnerable. And this is going to normalize it for the world if we all start little by little showing up for ourselves, showing up for the ways that we most need to for ourselves, then we are more willing to show up in the world. Okay? So to review, be compassionate, be willing to inquire with curiosity, what is really going on? Do you really need to rest? Do you really need to not show up? Or is there a way that it can happen, that you can do it in a way that's really in alignment? And that's where we get real. We be real. We be willing to be imperfect. We be willing to be vulnerable, be willing to show ourselves to the world in a less than perfect way that is actually totally normal, perfect, and beautiful, and gives everybody else permission. It gives the world permission to show up in their vulnerability when you do, when you show up less than your highest vibrational self, right? we can do this, we can do this and still be connected to the world. We can be in our suffering, we can be in our pain and still be connected to the world. We don't have to hide out, right? And be compassionate, right? I said that. The other thing I want to say, something that always is really powerful for me, and in being compassionate, I don't want to just invite you to do that for yourself, but also to do that for others. To be compassionate when you see perhaps that waitress or that whoever it may be is not having a good day and you want to just criticize and say, God, well, they're rude. Well, they're this, they're that. You don't know what that person has been through that day. You don't know what they may have experienced in their life. You don't know if it might be hard for them to just be showing up to work that day. And so being compassionate, it is not just towards yourself, of course, though that's where it starts. It's being compassionate to others and being willing to let others have a hard day too. And if they're showing up to work, if they're there in front of you, then that might be one of the most difficult things that they accomplished that day. And let's celebrate and honor that in each other, in ourselves. There's a beautiful quote, be kind, for every person you meet is fighting a harsh battle. And that's attributed to Plato and Socrates and several different people, actually. I'm sure that there's many people throughout time who has had that suggestion for how we can really be loving, compassionate human beings. Be kind, because everyone you meet is fighting a harsh battle, inside, outside, in the world. And that we got to start to be there for each other and really start to be kind in allowing ourselves to show up in imperfection. And be brave. Show up, be brave, ask for what you need. Ask for the conditions you need in order to show up so that you feel like you're taken care of, so that you feel nourished, supported, like you've done what you need to do for your self-care so that you can show up. Okay, I hope that's helpful. Lots of love to you. I look forward to seeing you in the next video, and blessings to you.